don't miss any content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Hey guys, welcome back to Sahara Football. As usual, I am your host, Selassie Fiawe. Today we're going to get some reaction from the draw that was held yesterday. That's the World Cup 2022 qualifiers draw. Coach CK Akono was there along with Mark Addo, who is the vice president of the Ghana Football Association and the general secretary. They were all there, and Coach CK Akono has expressed his opinion about the draw. We'll be hearing from him as well. Sonny Akuba might not play in the game between Kumasi Asante Kotoko and Accra Hartlepool at the Accra Sports Stadium on Sunday. The Super Clash, that will be the only game on Sunday, but Yakuba will be absent. Reports indicating he has submitted a transfer request. His transfer talks extension have been stalled because he wants $150,000 annual income from Kumasi Asante Kotoko, who are saying they cannot afford that much amount. And Andre Ayew has won 14 points for Swansea City this season. That's an amazing statistic there. Legon City's versus Bechem United, Medical will be performing once again as Legon City's keep on producing amazing stars to perform at the Accra Sports Stadium for them. And we'll hear from Fatau Dauda, who was accused in 2014 of using black magic, which you call here juju, to take the goalkeeping position from Adam Kwara. Say he has responded to those claims as well. If you're new to the channel, I advise you to subscribe to the channel and to click on the notification bell to get more updates. Check out our merch as well. Links are in the description. So we all know that the World Cup 2022 draws are now set. Now 10 groups with 4 teams. Ghana find themselves in Group G with South Africa, Zimbabwe, and also Ethiopia. Now Coach CK Akono, who is the newly appointed coach of the Ghana Black Stars, has expressed his thoughts on the draw that was held last night in Egypt. And it was really interesting to see the group that Ghana was in. Ghana was placed in pot one, and we were hoping for a favorable draw. Many people are indicating that this draw is a cool one for Ghana, and possibly we will not have any issues qualifying out of this group. Remember, only one team can make it out of the group stages, and there will be 10 teams left. Both teams will be paired, and they will play in a playoff game, home and away, to determine who makes it to represent Africa in the World Cup 2022. Now, CK Akono spoke after the draw, and this is what he had to say. Let's go have a listen to the Ghana Black Stars coach, CK Akono.
To all the teams, I know everybody is a desire for every team to qualify. We put in the hard work to qualify. You know, Ghana is a great football nation, and it is our dream to get to the World Cup. Saying this, we know all the teams, South Africa, Zimbabwe, and others, will do their bit to get there, but we put in hard work, and we know that hard work pays.
When Ghana qualified for the first time for the World Cup, it was at the expense of South Africa as well in 2006. So this time, do you think you can bring the Black Stars back to the World Cup after a spell of absence, after the Golden Generation has retired?
Well, the last one we went was Brazil. You know, we didn't qualify for that then, so we are hoping and believing that this is the time for us to do it. But then it's important that we put in hard work. It is the desire, like I said, desire for all these teams to qualify. But we will put a lot of work on the desire to work hard and to achieve that.
Yes, so you heard from CK Akono there. He, from his talk, was emphasizing on hard work. And I think you won't fault him for saying that. Hard work will get us the results. We don't have to underestimate any team in this round. And this will be a tricky test for Ghana. If South Africa was the country we overcame to make it to our very first World Cup in 2006, and really, we can overcome them. We are in the same group with them in the AFCON 2021 qualifier. We beat them in Cape Coast in their first game there, and we are well on our way to qualifying for the AFCON 2021. Thankfully, we can do same with the World Cup qualifiers. Hopefully, the World Cup qualifiers will be one to remember. 2018 was not the best of qualifiers for Ghana. We were not able to make it to the tournament. Egypt overcame us and went to the tournament for the first time in 28 years, and that was something that many Ghanaians missed. They missed Ghana at the World Cup. No African team made it out of the group stages in 2018. Senegal going out on fair play rules. Quite historic moment there, but quite sad for Africa. Hopefully Ghana can make us proud, can make it to the next stage of the competition, which is round three and the playoff place, and possibly into the World Cup in 2022. So that was the thoughts of CK Akono there. Do you agree with him? I think I tend to agree with him. Hard work is the only way. We can't underestimate any team. We dare not underestimate any team, because that will be our own peril. And I think he's sounding or saying the right things as the new boss of the Ghana Black Stars. Your thoughts are welcome in the comments box on this. I move on to my next story. It has to do with Fatau Dauda. Now, Fatau Dauda in 2014 played for the Ghana Black Stars. Many people accused him of using black magic, which is usually called juju, to take the goalkeeping position from Adam Kouassi. At that time, Adam Kouassi was a top goalkeeper who did not understand why Fatau Dauda was allowed to take his place in the final game against Portugal, where the Black Stars lost 2-0 after so many issues with bonuses and allowances and so many issues, players threatening to boycott the game because of unpaid bonuses and allowances. Now, Fatau Dauda has come to clear the air on that issue. Now, the Ghanaian goalkeeper who plays for Legon Cities has shut down claims that he influenced the freezing out of Adam Kouassi from the national team. Kouassi initially went to Brazil 2014 as the undisputed first choice goalkeeper and started the first group game against the United States. After losing 2-1 to the Americans, Kouassi was relegated to the bench by Kwesi Appiah for their next game against Germany for Fatau to take the goalkeeping duties. Some rumors surfaced that Dauda had used his relationship with other members of the team to get Kouassi benched. Others also believe that there was a mystical source of Kouassi's terrible performance in his first match, and they believe that Fatau Dauda had used juju to achieve that. However, he told City TV that couldn't be far from the truth. Ghanaians have been saying it, and I've heard it, I've been hearing it. That's how our job is. You hear a lot of things about you. If I had juju, I would go and play outside with Real Madrid or Barcelona and make big money. I train and pray to God to protect me from injuries. I don't know where these rumors are coming from. That's quite interesting there from Fatau Dauda. He does not have black magic. He does not have juju. If he did, he will play for Real Madrid or FC Barcelona. That's according to the Ghanaian goalkeeper who plays for Legon Cities. And speaking of Legon Cities, they will be playing Bechem United on Friday night at 6 p.m. at the Accra Sports Stadium. They are keeping up with the performances of musicians at the stadium. This time around, Medical will be there to perform for Legon Cities. At halftime, he will be performing there at the stadium. Last time out, it was Kwesi Appiah, and before then, it was Shatta Wale. So, Legon City's goalkeeper Fatau Dauda debunking those rumors there. He doesn't have black magic. If he had, he would go outside the country and be playing for a team like Real Madrid or FC Barcelona. And I think it's quite unfortunate that people think he has that kind of magic to be doing that those things to players like Adam Kouassi. Clearly, Kwesi Appiah was not impressed with his first game performance and decided to bench him and play Fatau Dauda. Burkina Faso international Sonye Yakuba has handed in a transfer request, according to reporting. He might not be included in the team to play Accra Hearts of Oak at the Accra Sports Stadium, the Super Clash on Sunday. Now, the Burkina Faso international has told Ghanaian giant Accra Hearts of Oak he wants to leave the club and join Egyptian Premier League side FC Smuha, according to Kumasi-based Kespen FM. Now, the 28-year-old goal poacher has failed to renew his contract with the Red Jerseys Porcupine Warriors despite several attempts by the Babayaro club to get him to commit to a new deal. Kotoko boss Dr. Kwame Che revealed that it was impossible for Kotoko to pay him the amount he was asking for, $150,000. Now, Kumasi Asantekotoko reset his price Yakuba higher than that, but why can't they pay that amount now? Now, according to a report by Kesben FM, Kotoko's hierarchy has decided against keeping the player and are set to invite a bid from Smuha, means that Mike Sokonedu is unlikely to include him in his 18-man squad that will be traveling to Accra for the game with Accra Hatofuk on Sunday. Kotoko seemed to have prepared for life after the striker, who is deemed the most dangerous player in their folds, by signing former Kerala United goal-getter William Opoku Mensah. So it's likely Yakuba might not be in the team for Kumasi Asante Kotoko when they face Accra Hatofuk on Sunday. Your thoughts in the comments box are welcome. Many people feel he's not doing enough to warrant such a pay rise. What do you think about this? Do you think Kotoko should calm down with this rumor? Do you think he should play on Sunday? Your thoughts in the comments box. And to my final story, Andre Ayew. Amazing stats coming out from the camp of Andre Ayew. He said he is responsible for 14 points for Swansea City this season. And amazing statistic there from Andre Ayew. He's having a great season with Swansea City, who previously did not want him to stay at the club, wanted to offload him because of his high wage demands. And now he is their main man and he is their top earner, and rightly so. I'm so happy for him and his amazing statistic. 14 points for Swansea City this season, that is no mean feat. So that has been it for today. Coach CK Akono's reaction to the World Cup 2022 qualifier draw. We are in the same group with Zimbabwe, Ethiopia and South Africa. We will play and only one team will make it to round three. He says hard work is the mantra going forward, and I couldn't agree any more. He couldn't have said it any better. Hard work is the key. No way we can underestimate any team at this point. We've also heard from Fatou Daouda, who says he doesn't have black magic. If he did, he would have used it to play outside the country and make a lot of money. I tend to agree with him on that. And Yakuba said to leave Kumasi Asante Kotoko, and the amazing statistic there from camp off Andre Ayew, 14 points he has secured for Swansea City this term. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.